For the second night in a row, the Huskies score 5 goals to get the win over Colorado College. Helen, welcome inside the studio for your postgame report. I'm your host, Joe Scarella. St. Cloud State gets it done as they complete the sweep and stay perfect on home ice. We're going to take a look back at how the Huskies got it done, starting things off in the first period. Normally, it's David Hrenik between the pipes on Saturday, but today it would be Jeff Smith getting the call as Coach Motzko decides to go with what worked. Tigers with the first chance of the night. Jack Gates sashaying around the net. He gets one on Smith, who's right back where he left off, and that's perfect. Huskies with a chance of their own. Blake Lizotte, point blank, receives a pass, but just whistles his backhand over the bar. Mashad takes a seat in the box for roughing, and the Huskies to their first power play of the night. On that power play, the Huskies made him pay. Great puck movement around the perimeter. It touches every home stick and finds Chica Benson, who wasn't going to miss that wide open at St. Cloud State, gets on the board, and they lead by one heading into the locker room. In the second period, physical play started to ramp up. Mikey Asimont is absolutely smeared along the boards as the Tigers try to claw their way back. Chance of the game for Colorado. Mishad with the shot, and Gooch follows up, but Jeff Smith with a remarkable save to keep the one-goal lead. Jackson with a chance to extend the lead to 2 as he comes down the side. His shot rifles the stick right out of LeClaire's hand, and the goaltender able to get the job done. Smith had to be just as good, though. A Colorado shot rings the iron, and a follow-up chance is swallowed up as Smith is able to get the glove on it. Both goaltenders remain perfect there in the second period. In the third period, on the power play, the Huskies make some more magic. Jack Ashon embarrasses the defense. Nick Paling feeds Easton Brodzinski, and the Huskies extend their lead to 2 on an absolutely gorgeous goal. The hometown wasn't done yet, though. Great puck movement on the point, and Luke Jaycox attacks. A missile from the blue line slips through, and the Huskies have a 3-goal advantage early in the third. Smith would get a call, and he would answer. Tempers would flare as the Tigers were desperately needing a goal. Penalties on both ends, but the Tigers on a 4-on-3 power play. It's Mason Berg who goes blocker side top shelf to give the Tigers the jump they were looking for. Berg's 9th of the season. He's 7th in the nation in scoring. Huskies on a 5-minute chance of their own, though. A melee in front, Newell giving everything he's got. It slowly trickles in, and Pat Newell gets his 2nd of the season. CC's last-ditch effort on the power play, but a bad turnover in the offensive zone leads to Jund Peterson, who's been snake-bit on the season, but he finds a way to put it in the empty net. St. Cloud State goes on to win this one 5-1 over Colorado College. Shots on goal, Huskies roll again, 39-23. Block shots in favor of the Huskies tonight. It was in favor of CC last night, 17-10. The Huskies win in that category. Penalties, a lot of them on both ends. 8 for Colorado College, 7 times the Huskies went to the box. Power plays 1-for-5 Colorado College, and St. Cloud State 3-for-7, again dominant on their power play chances. Faceoffs, Huskies roll in that category as well, 36-23. We're going to take a listen to what Coach Motzko had to say after tonight's big win.
Special teams played a big part in a stretch in that game, but I thought we played well from start to finish. Our guys came ready to play all weekend. We had some coming of age of a couple of players, of young players. You know, we go back to random thoughts. We go back to Smitty for the 2 nights in a row. He was outstanding. He was in a good groove. Luke Jaycox, best game of the year. That's what guy coming of age. I thought he was outstanding tonight. Brodzinski gets another goal. He was in my doghouse a little bit early in the game, but he fought through it. Real solid defensive game, and they played really hard. I mean, that was a much closer game than the score. A couple power play goals were changing for us, but very pleased how we played. And they were much more physical. They were meeting us at impact at the blue line. So we were, you know, when we got pucks deep, we were pretty good. But they stopped us from getting deep a lot of times, which that's why shots were 8-8 after 1. I looked up another time, they're 15-15. They were going toe-to-toe up and down the rink, and the power play tonight was, you know, getting the first goal was huge, and then obviously, you know, goal 1 and 2 when we get a couple special teams, and then penalty kill was excellent when it needed to be.
Coach Motzko and the rest of the St. Cloud State Huskies roll. Luke Jaycox, phenomenal on the night as he gets his first collegiate goal. The Huskies next week will be in Omaha, and then they'll be back on home ice following that. Thank you for joining us here on Husky Productions and your post-game report. I'm your host, Joe Scarella. St. Cloud State gets the win 5-1.